Welcome to the fifth lecture of this series where we are learning how to write a thesis in LaTeX. In the last lecture, we prepared a page of preface and a page of declaration. Now, in this lecture, we are going to prepare a page of summary and a Turkish translation of that summary, which is called özet in Turkish language. So, let's start it by creating a separate text file for summary. Add a new page here. Add that summary here. The summary of this thesis looks like this. There is some text at the top of this page. Then comes this summary of the thesis. At the bottom, we have some keywords of this thesis. Similarly, the next page is just the translation of summary. Let's start preparing the summary page of this thesis here. A centered environment for the text which was at the top of the summary page. I'm going to copy and paste the text here. The line spacing of this text is little bit less than the text above it, so we'll have to create a separate environment for just this text with separate line spacings. Use the command setstretch. And copy the text from the thesis and paste it here within these brackets. Here is the first paragraph of the summary. Indent it. There is a small text here which is actually italic, so I am going to use a math mode here, which is also used to write all the stuff which is related to mathematics, like equations, numbers, and these mathematical operators as well. I am going to copy paste the second paragraph of the summary. The math mode is always created by using the dollar sign, and the text is placed between these two dollar signs like this. Now comes the second paragraph of this summary. You can see this number is also placed within this math mode environment. These numbers as well. The multiplication sign in LaTeX is placed by using the command backslash times. Then comes this number, followed by these two non-breaking spaces around this equal sign. These non-breaking spaces are actually used to save the text from splitting into two parts while moving from one line to the next line. Now copy the last paragraph from here. It is always a best practice to indent the elements such that these indents indicates different hierarchy levels of the document. Now the last element of this summary page is these keywords. The line spacings of these keywords is less than the line spacing of the main text of this page. For this, we are going to create a separate environment of, let's say, 1.2 line spacings here. Inside this environment, we will have a bold text. These keywords will come outside of this bold environment, but inside this 1.2 line spacing environment. Let's save it. Look at the difference in line spacings in the main text of summary and these keywords. The line spacings in the main text is I think of 1, whereas those of the keywords it is 1.2. Debugging is another art of programming. You will not become master of programming unless you learn how to trace those problems. So let's see at which point the line spacings is being changed to 1 in the summary. We actually wanted to change the line spacing to 1 for this small text only, but mistakenly we placed this line spacing command outside of these curly brackets. So as a result, it changes the line spacing of the environment in which this line spacing command is right now, which is the center environment here. So I placed it inside here now so that it only changes the line spacing within these curly brackets only and does not affect the main center environment. The whole summary was not supposed to be within the centered environment. So we are going to end the centered environment below this text here before starting the main content of the summary. There is some indent in the second line, splitting this text from here such that it aligns vertically with the first line at the top. There are two ways in my mind to do so. One is to create a table of two columns, and the second one is to do it by hard coding and by inserting horizontal space in the second line manually, which I am going to do here now. So split this text from here, add a line, and then add some horizontal space of 2.5 centimeter. To be on the safe side, I am going to add a no indent in the first line before these keywords here. The edge space command didn't work here. Maybe the LaTeX thinks that I did some kind of mistake by adding edge space here. So I'll have to force horizontal space here by using asterisk here. So this summary is ready now. Let's move on to the Turkish translation of this summary, which is 100% identical in structure of the page. I'll try to prepare this page quickly. Copy this structure and go to the OZ and paste it. I'm going to paste the translated version of this text. The main body of this Turkish summary is also ready. Let's go and add this ztext file in the main document. Generate a new page. add this courgette from external files, save. We made the same mistake here as well by placing the main body of this summary in the centered environment. Both the summary pages are ready now. In the next lecture, we are going to generate the list of symbols. Till then, take care of yourself and do not forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you.